Welcome back to Living 808. It is still a big problem. The coconut rhinoceros beetle continues to do major damage here in the islands, but there are companies out there trying to find an effective solution to what has now been labeled a crisis. Joining us to talk more about their solution is George Fleming, owner of Coastline Nursery, and James Murray, owner of Aloha Tree Savers. Aloha, you guys.
Good morning.
Good morning. And you brought some other guests for us, too. Yes. So we're going to talk a little bit about those coming up in just a bit. But James, I want to start with you. Let's talk about the infestation in Hawaii and how it came to be.
It originally came back from Southeast Asia into Guam. The species that we actually have on Oahu is the one from Guam. And it there is millions and millions of these beetles seeding our trees.
Okay, and then of course they came to your attention in a really big way.
Yeah, originally I actually heard of the problem from George's nursery. He called me and he said, I need help getting this to all the trees to save Hawaii's trees.
Wow. Okay, so George, let's talk about it then. How bad is the problem here from what you've seen? And, you know, again, I understand that your nursery has been impacted pretty significantly.
Right, the nursery was really impacted. We're up in Kunia, which is a hot spot. And we were starting to see damage like this, like on this frond. You know, all these cut leaves, we had no idea what it was, and then we... With the help of the ag department here in Hawaii, they came out and they told us what was going on. So then we, unfortunately, by that time, we lost over $100,000 worth of trees that we had to bury because there's no way of getting rid of them. We can't even take them to the landfill or anything. Oh. So the other owner, Barbara Francis, couldn't even come to the nursery for several weeks because she was so distraught because we grew everything from seeds. But we came across this product, the PTWK, which they reached out to us from overseas. And we tried it, and now we have 3.5 acres of trees, and we're beetle free. And we had thousands of beetles. They were everywhere. So then we became the distributor, and now we're offering this to the public, and James is you know, moving the product, you know, through his sources.
Incredible.
We were seeing damage like that, and then this is what it looks like when it drills right into the trunk of a tree.
Whoa.
So if anybody sees little bird nests on their trees or damage like this, you have the beetle.
Really?
This happens down inside the tree before. Some people think this is happening like outside the tree when a beetle lands on it and eats it. This actually is happening down inside the tree. So by the time you see that, you already have an infestation.
And it's bad.
So what exactly is that? Is that what they eat away at?
That's down inside the tree, and that is actual beetle chomping damage right on that tree.
The beetle has eaten that.
So if they can't get in the top of the tree, then they'll bore right into the side of the tree. It's the most voracious thing I've ever seen.
That's good to know because it's been in the news like crazy. So, we've heard of it. We've seen pictures of the beetles. But to actually see what the damage is, because I've definitely seen trees that have a lot of that. So, okay, you talked about, though, that you used this at the nursery. All of the beetles are gone. So let's talk about it. What exactly is Aloha Tree Savers doing?
I don't want to mislead anybody. All the beetles are gone because they're continually flying in from people that aren't treating trees.
Right. Yeah.
So it's a constant battle for everybody.
Right. We just have to do everything we can to get as many trees saved. So what we're doing is we're taking this bit and we're drilling around the circumference of the trees, and then we about a foot deep, and then we mix this with water, and then it's a soil drench, and the product goes up into the tree, and then it fights the beetles itself.
Oh, interesting.
And when the beetle eats the tree, similar to this, it suffocates and dies.
Got it. Okay, so, but the solution then doesn't damage the tree itself.
So the solution is actually very, very environmentally friendly. You can still eat the coconuts, drink the coconut water, safe for pets, safe for the pollinators. The bees are happy to be around and pollinate the coconuts for us. And that's super important. For Hawaii life.
And another thing this product does, which other treatments don't do, is antibacterial and antifungal properties
mixed in with
it. It also breaks down the soluble salts in the soil, which are really fertilizers, that enables the tree to take that fertilizer up and become more healthy, because we really believe that a more healthy tree can withstand the attack better.
And we're
all about trying to make the tree happy and healthy at the same time.
Yeah.
That makes a lot of sense.
A stronger tree is going to be able to fight stronger.
So. Perfect. And fight against those. And yeah. I mean, those are some live larvae. I see them squirming around. Right.
Yeah.
So what are the, I'm assuming it's the larger one that does the damage. But right. then are this, those?
The beetle actually has a mission to kill the tree because the larvae only eat dead and decaying organic matter. So the beetle comes along and wants to kill the tree. It lays the eggs around the tree so that when the tree dies, its babies have something to eat.
All right, and I'm going to reach over here and tilt this.
That's very brave of you.
See. I know.
Yeah, very brave.
Not going to lie. I'm not loving it. And so,
if you see grubs like this, too, this very characteristic C shape is how you know it's the grub that's associated with the rhino beetle, because we have other grubs here in Hawaii that are pests, but this one wants to be this C shape. And that's how you know it's this guy right here.
Right. Oh, interesting.
And each female has 80 babies in its lifetime. So it's an exponential growth.
Right.
So if we don't start killing the... So after three life cycles, we're talking 150,000 beetles. So that's why there's millions of beetles here in Hawaii now. And so we just have to actively start...
And that's why it's become such a crisis. And as you say, you know, even when things are treated, it's better. They can still fly in. So we have to really keep on top of this. Correct. If people want to learn more about the business, how can folks reach you guys?
Well, we have a great phone number, 808-808-TREE. And our website is AlohaTreeSavers.com. And we will come out and do an assessment of your trees, how many you have, and what we can do to help you. And hopefully moving forward, you know, we can win the fight.
Definitely. And of course, we'll have a link to your website on our website at kh12.com. And if folks are interested in coming out and supporting your nursery, where do we find you guys?
Well, just through James.
Through James as well.
I'll refer you guys to George. He's great. So
perfect.
He's working with us on this tree. He's, you know, they're very passionate after losing all of his trees and stuff like that.
We lost a big chunk of our retirement.
And I'm sure so many others are in the same boat and would love to get more info. So again, we'll have that on our website, k22.com. Thanks so much for being here, you guys.
Thank you.